Did you guys know that there are over 17,500 NCAA men's college basketball players? And did you know that out of all these players, a bare minimum 227 actually go pro? That is a 1.3% chance of making it to the NBA. Hello, my name is Mauricio Martinez, and I am here to speak to you lovely people about the huge debate that has to do with college athletes getting paid or not. Being a new and upcoming college athlete myself, and having many friends that also abide by the rules and regulations and play under the NCAA college sports program, gives me personal experience and ideas towards whether or not college athletes should in fact get paid. We are all currently college students with a voice and different ideas regardless if you play a sport or not, correct? Some truly believe that athletes in college should be paid for the sport they play, while others believe otherwise. Today, I will speak about the debate on student athletes getting paid or not. This topic has been spoken about for many years now, and the NCAA has been criticized for their way of handling their college athletes. Along with the opinion of current players, ex-players, coaches, and many other people, hopefully you will be able to decide on this huge debate that is still going on to this day. My main points include giving multiple reasons as to why the NCAA should in fact pay their players, giving multiple reasons as to why the NCAA is corrupt and treats its athletes very unfairly, and for my last point, reasons to why I believe college athletes should in fact get paid. Michael Lewis is one of the many people that believe athletes should in fact be paid. He centers his argument at the fact that college athletes make their schools millions and billions of dollars. Although it costs a lot of money to maintain these programs, the money made from these athletes is way more. The student athlete's hard work is getting exploited by rich institutions with little reward is very unfair. Student athletes sell thousands of shirts and merchandise for their respective schools and do not receive a single penny or dollar of this profit. How crazy does that sound, ladies and gentlemen? A lot of these athletes use their sport as the only way out of tough neighborhoods they grew up in to attend expensive schools in search for a chance to go pro. If it wasn't for that, they would be stuck due to some of these athletes not having good enough grades to attend these schools, not enough money to attend these schools, and so on. These athletes train so hard with long hours every week that a serious injury could make them lose their scholarship if deemed unable to play or deemed unable to play for a while. That is where paying these athletes comes in handy to insure them financially in case they get hurt. These athletes put their bodies and time and dedication on the line for their respective schools. Giving them money is the least they should receive for their efforts. In college, these athletes are treated in a professional environment, correct? So why don't these athletes get paid like professional athletes, if that's the case? Lewis says the hard work they put in is not enough with just scholarship money. Yes, getting help with tuition and etc. is sweet, but being able to provide for yourself and your family has to be one of the best feelings in the world. There is nothing like receiving cash from the sport you love, and being able to provide and put food on the table for yourself at the bare minimum age of 18 and so on. Here, I have some percentages and a chart showing certain sports with college athletes making it to the professional level. For the MLB, 8.6% of college athletes go professional. In football, 1.6% make it to the NFL. Basketball, 1.3% make it to the NBA. And in soccer, 1.4% of these college athletes go to the MLS. That says a lot about the NCAA and how many of these athletes work so hard to go pro, but not everyone will make it. The NCAA has been around for a while. Many think they treat the athletes wrong and just use them for revenue. It is in many ways corrupt. The athletes that abide by the NCAA's rules or laws should in fact be paid. A study has shown that asked if college athletes were to receive money for their performance levels, would it rise, making the organization better for entertainment and business? A poll said, yes, it would. 70% to 30% saying it wouldn't. The priority of the NCAA is to not only help the players, but to also help them grow as adults and not be an eager, money-making organization that doesn't care about its athletes. It is a fact that not everyone will go on to play professional, so changing the restrictions of the NCAA should be done. Today, sports and athletics in the NCAA draw in around $11 billion every year, and none of it goes towards the athletes working so hard for the championship and for the ultimate prize, a chance to go pro. To make matters worse, is college athletes spend an average 43.3 hours every week dedicated to their sport, making it equivalent to a full-time job with absolutely no pay. I truly believe that college athletes should very much get paid. While it is true, these athletes are often on scholarships that cover tuition, accommodation fees, room and board, and often given meal plans many times. This is not the case for everyone. Not everyone receives the same amount of money. Some get more help than others. I think that paying the students comes with a lot of great benefits and learning experiences. I believe paying them would only make the sport more competitive, and adding a salary would help student athletes learn how to manage their money better. In conclusion, the ongoing debate between college athletes getting paid or not is still going for years and years to come. College athletes getting paid right now is something to look for the future, and hopefully helped raise some questions and eyebrows from some of you in the crowd. Hi, my name is Mauricio Martinez. I thank you all for your time.